So, on what base you have seen is based on cell division and cell differentiation. Based on these two properties, the plant cells are deep. Classified into two types of tissues. Number one, meristematic tissue, and number two, permanent tissue. These are the two types of tissues that are found in plants. Now, if I observe the meristematic tissues, being these types of tissues, they consisting of all the cells are similar. These meristematic tissue cells undergoes cell division to produce new cells. They are able to divide and produce new cells. But even if they are producing new cells, these new cells, what is happening here? They are not able to differentiate, or these are undifferentiated cells that are found in meristematic tissue. So these cells can divide and undifferentiate. What the cells of meristematic tissue is, they all are similar, but these cells can divide, but they are not undifferentiated. Means they can't differentiate into different types of tissues to carry out different function. These tissues are meristematic tissue. Next, permanent tissue. Here, reverse to the meristematic tissue. These do not divide, but they can differentiate to carry out different functions. That's what differentiation is, nothing but transformation. They are transforming to carry out a different function. That is a differentiation. So meristematic tissue, they are able to divide, and undifferentiated types of cells are present. But in case of permanent tissue, the cells are not able to divide, but they can differentiate to perform different function. That is what two types of tissues that form in plant. Now we will discuss about meristematic tissue and the types of meristematic tissue. If you observe the meristematic tissue, as you have seen, all the cells are similar. Our cells are similar, and these cells are found in growing part of the plant. Where these meristematic tissue is found, it is found in growing part. Generally, what is growing part of the plant? Like root, stem, and branches. In these growing part, what is found is meristematic tissue. Understand? So, if you observe, these meristematic tissue are also called as apical meristematic. They are also called apical meristematic tissue. So, meristematic tissue is also called as apical meristematic tissue. And these meristematic tissues are formed after immediate birth of the plant. Means after seedling itself, they start formation. That's why the meristematic tissue is also called as primary tissue. Understand? So these are formed by the birth of the plant. So what it is called as? Primary tissues. Understand? Now, characteristic features on the meristematic tissue. We'll continue here. If you observe, in this type of tissue, the cells are surrounded by means of a thin membrane structure. What do we call as cell wall? And this cell wall is usually made up of a cellulose. The cells surrounded by thin cell wall made of cellulose. It is made up of a cellulose. And if you observe the shape of these meristematic tissue cells, is in general they are round in shape or maybe oval in shape or maybe polygonal in shape. This is the shape of the meristematic tissue cells. And if you observe, they consisting of large in size of the nucleus. How is the nucleus is here? Large size. Nucleus is present. That is the thing. And if you observe, in case of meristematic tissue, the cells may be they consisting of vacuole or may be absent. Understand? So what is happening here? A vacuole may be present or may not present. That is the condition. Vacuole present or absent. That is the thing. And next we observe, these meristematic tissue cells, they are very closely packed. Understand? Means there is no gap in between adjacent cells. So, cells are closely packed. They are very close together each other. Due to the very closeness of the cells, and if you observe, there is no gap in between cells. Means in between two cells, if there is a gap, that is called as intercellular space. Understand? So the intercellular space is absent in case of a meristematic tissues. Understand? So what is absent here? Intercellular space is not present, that is absent. Understand? And if you observe, these cells of this meristematic tissue, they undergo cell division to produce new cells. So, cell divides to produce new cells. They are producing the new cells. That is another important. And these new cells, very important, the new cells produced are transformed or differentiated into permanent cells. Understand? They are transformed into permanent cells or permanent tissues. That is what these permanent tissues, which we can call them as permanent tissues. And that usually carry a different function. That's what the characteristic features of the meristematic tissue. So what are the characteristic features is cells of meristematic tissue are similar. They are found usually in growing part of the plant like roots, stem and branches. These are also called as apical meristematic tissue. Why it is called as apical meristematic tissue? Because they are found at the apex, means at the tip of the plant. Understand? And they are formed by the bark of the plant. That's what they are called as primary tissues. And these are surrounded by a thin cell wall. And it is made up of cellulose. And these in general, round in shape, oval in shape, are to be found in polygonal in shape. And these consisting and the ragged may be present or may not be present. And if you observe, the cells are closely packed, means they are very close to each other. That is the thing. And intercellular space is absent. What is not present? There is no gap in between the cells. And these cells divide to produce new cells. Understand? These new cells produced are differentiated to permanent tissues or cells of the permanent tissue. Understand? This is what we see the characteristic feature of the meristematic tissue. Now, we will discuss the types of meristematic tissue. The meristematic tissues are of three types. How many types of meristematic tissue are there? Three types of meristematic tissue are there. What are the three types of meristematic tissue? That is, we have to learn. See, number one, apical meristematic meristematic tissue. Next, we will continue with the types of meristematic tissue.